Mille pipes, joue, 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 joue. Mille pipes, ask a question, miam, miam, miam. Mille pipes.
I hear the sound of a tractor on the wind that lifts her perfume through the air. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. Softly smile, I know she.
Holiday Reese's, let me show you how to make them. I went with pumpkins and brains.
Lily's chocolate chips,
coconut oil, melt that down in the microwave. I do about 10 second increments. I transfer some to a dish because we're gonna save this for later. And I'm gonna get our little mold and then add about a teaspoon to each. And then roll that around so it gets evenly coated on all of the sides. I'm gonna do pumpkins and then these little brains. Into the freezer for about 10 minutes to set up. No sugar added peanut butter and a little bit more coconut oil. Once you get that smooth consistency, we're gonna add it to a piping bag because it just makes the process a little easier. And then fill these babies up with that peanut butter mixture. Back in the freezer for another 15 minutes.
Finish it off with chocolate.
Back to the freezer one more time for about an hour.
Hey friends, it's getting spooky around here. I bet you've seen hot cocoa bombs all over the internet, but have you seen cauldron hot cocoa bombs? Just a fair warning, this drink is not for the faint of heart, so if you don't like spooky food, you should probably skip to the next video. It's topped with bubbling green chocolate and all kinds of spooky sprinkles and eyeballs. But the real trial here is if this baby will melt under pressure. So let's pop her in a cup and see how she does. In goes some boiled swamp juice. I think the Sanderson sisters would be very proud.
Today I'm gonna share with you how to make chocolate covered mummies.
Melt white coating wafers according to package directions. Dip a 4-inch candy stick in the chocolate and then in a marshmallow. Freeze for 2 minutes. Now dip the entire marshmallow back in the chocolate and shake off any excess chocolate. You can find all items needed for this recipe at any Hobby Lobby, Michaels, or Amazon. Lay your marshmallow on parchment and then apply your candy eyes. In a small piping or Ziploc bag, pour the rest of your chocolate. Snip off the tip and now you're ready to drizzle. While rotating, you're going to drizzle the chocolate all around your marshmallow, creating a realistic mummy look. Repeat this process with all remaining marshmallows, and then once again, you're going to freeze for 5 minutes. Remove from the freezer and then repeat this process one more time. This is a super fun activity to do with kids. And now you have chocolate covered mummies. Enjoy.
I'm decorating a 2-inch pumpkin cookie today. This cookie cutter is from Sweet Sugar Bell, and I'm outlining and flooding with the same icing. I do have a tutorial a few videos back if you want to check that out, but I don't share my cookie recipe because it took me over a year to tweak and get it just right, but I might offer it for sale on my website eventually. Now I'm adding eyeballs with black 4mm sugar pearls by PME, and then I'm gonna add eyebrows and a little squiggly line for a mouth with my Tweets Cookie Connection super fine detail food marker. This blush is by a company called The Sugar Art, and I paired him with some friends.
You know those caramel apple lollipops you find at the store? They're so easy to make at home and they taste so much better. And they're so much fun. You just need a lollipop stick and 4 green Jolly Ranchers. 350 in your oven for 4 to 5 minutes, and then shape it around the lollipop stick to the shape that you'd like. Take some caramels, throw them into a pan with 2 tablespoons of heavy whipping cream, mix it, and then you wanna just spoon it right over your lollipops. If you have a way for this not to stick to wax paper, let me know. A little bit of flaky salt. It's everything. Let us know if you try it.
Today we're going to be making Halloween Witch's Brew Fudge. Melt condensed milk and white chocolate on a low heat, stirring constantly until thick and smooth. Set aside a third of the mix in another bowl, then add green food coloring to the pan and mix this in. Add in some broken Oreos and fold these through, then add purple food coloring to the rest of the mix and stir this in. Dollop the green mix into your tin, leaving some gaps, then dollop the purple mix in the gaps and swirl it through with a knife. Press it down evenly, top with Halloween sprinkles and edible eyes, then let it set in the fridge. Enjoy!
I've been making a prosciutto head every Halloween for the last 6 years. It's always a big hit. Wash and sanitize a life-size plastic skull. Use cream cheese to glue your plastic eyeballs in the eye sockets. Next, use about 10 slices of room temperature prosciutto. Mold this on every part of the skull, leaving only the eyeballs and the teeth exposed. This can be made up to 1 week ahead of time. Just cover tightly with plastic and store in the fridge. I like to serve mine on a platter with charcuterie and cheese. Enjoy!
Favorite sweet and salty snack. It's perfect for Halloween, but just so you know, don't make this when you're home alone. You'll eat all of it. Another kind of chips. Gently start to move it around, and it'll slowly start to melt. You can totally melt white chocolate in the microwave. Be careful though, it's very finicky. Do it on like 10 second intervals. The double boiler method is just a little bit safer. So I'm going to turn this off. This is perfectly smooth, and then carefully take the glass bowl off and dump it right on top of the cereal mix. Fold everything together. You want all the cereal to be fully coated with the white chocolate. I'm just gonna need it to stick together. Grab a piece of parchment paper and just dump it out so it can dry and start to set.
Thank you. like creeping people out on Halloween, and sheet pan intestines is cheap, easy, and it's the perfect thing to do. Unroll your cinnamon rolls and put them on a sheet pan. I know this one looks dirty, but you know what? It goes with the theme. We're cooking intestines here. It's not supposed to look gorgeous. And freestyle it with the intestines. No one knows what they're really supposed to look like inside anyway. They cook faster when they're rolled out, so keep an eye on it. Now I just added red food coloring to the icing that they already gave me. Just keep adding and mixing until you get a color that resembles blood. And don't forget to give your assistant the final taste test approval. Now just pour that red icing or blood all over these intestines. You gotta have an imagination for this one, but it works. It kind of really does look like bloody intestines. Definitely a super easy way to get in the holiday spirit. I hope you like this one.
Here is a three-tier Halloween design cake, and of course I'm going to start by stacking the cake and doing a crumb coat, and then I'm going to use a striped cone for the final coat because this is a striped cake design. So I'm going to fill in all the spaces with orange buttercream, and then I'm going to carefully smooth this cake out until I get the stripes as clean as I can get them. Then I'm adding sprinkles for a bottom border, and then adding support straws to support the top tiers. And for the middle tier, I added black fondant to the cake using the paneling method. And then I added spider webs, which is just melted marshmallows. And this was so messy, but it was also so fun to do. And for the top tier, I used yellow, orange, and white frosting for a candy corn design. And then I smoothed it all out. So now I'm going to carefully stack the cake and then start adding all the details. So for the middle tier, I added candy eyeballs. And for the bottom tier, I added a black chocolate ganache drip. And the top tier, I added candy corn. And to top this whole cake off, I added a tiny Halloween bucket, and that's the cake complete.